Whenever there's a protest or conflict in India, we start hearing about internet shutdowns. So let's take a look back at the very recent past to understand the legality of internet shutdowns in India. Under the Indian Telegraph Act, the government has the power to block the transmission of messages when there is a public emergency. Now, prior to 2017, district magistrates would routinely impose internet shutdowns under Section 144. After 2017, we started using the telecom suspension rules. Now, some things to keep in mind at this point are that the indefinite suspension of internet is illegal in India, that all internet shutdowns must pass the tests of necessity and proportionality, that the Home Secretary of the central and the state governments must pass an official order for an internet shutdown along with a reason, and that a review committee must meet within 5 working days of an internet shutdown and record whether it is in accordance with the provisions of the Indian Telegraph Act. In August 2019, during the revocation of the special status of Jammu and Kashmir, a communication shutdown was imposed in the region. Access to SMSs, landlines, phone calls, mobile internet, fixed line internet were all gone. So Anuradha Bhasin, an executive editor at the Kashmir Times, filed a petition challenging this for reasons including that a newspaper cannot run without access to telecom or internet services. So the Supreme Court was called upon to determine the constitutionality of the shutdown in Jammu and Kashmir. In January 2020, in Anuradha Bhasin versus the Union of India, the Supreme Court directed that in addition to the telecom suspension rules, all orders restricting people's access to the internet must be made public and that a committee must review the internet shutdown orders every 7 working days. It was also reiterated, importantly, that the internet is a medium for us to exercise our freedom of speech and expression. The court said some pretty positive things, like, for example, even if the state is fighting a threat of terrorism, it cannot prohibit speech unless there is a likelihood of imminent violence, or that governments can't use logistical inconvenience or tech issues as an excuse to not publicly disclose internet shutdown orders. This was a pretty big deal because the SC was raising the bar of accountability for the government regarding internet shutdowns. In November 2020, there was a new rule stating that a single order cannot authorize internet shutdowns for more than 15 days. So all of these directions are well and good, but unfortunately, they haven't helped us as much as we thought they would. The Internet Freedom Foundation found out via RTIs that there is low compliance by state governments with the judgment of the SC in Anuradha Bhasin versus the Union of India. For example, an IFF staffer filed an RTI seeking information about internet shutdowns in Madhya Pradesh. The Home Department got back saying that they are constitutionally exempt from providing an answer. Another RTI was filed seeking information about internet shutdowns in Meghalaya, and the Home Department got back saying that they weren't even aware of the SC's decision in the matter because they never received it. This shows an obvious failure of transparency, accountability, and awareness. It's a problem that public orders for internet shutdowns are not being given, because without access to these orders, we cannot seek judicial review in matters of arbitrary or disproportionate internet shutdowns, which is to say we effectively can't seek accountability. And also, internet shutdowns, they lead to massive economic losses. So we need record keeping at the level of the state and central government so that we can engage in evidence-based policy reform. When we don't have internet shutdown orders, we rely on the media to find out about them. The media can be inconsistent, and also they do not represent the full scale of the problem because they may not report internet shutdowns that happen for a very short duration or are happening in small towns and villages. We also need these orders for accountability because through the media itself, we're finding out that in places like Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, and West Bengal, government authorities who are not authorized to impose internet shutdowns are doing so. There are other glaring issues as well. For example, a maximum period of 15 days per internet shutdown order is actually not very helpful because in many regions, internet shutdowns don't last that long, but they still have a devastating impact on people's access to communication and information. And also, this was introduced without any public consultation. In February 2020, the Minister of State for Communications said in the Rajya Sabha that the central government will review the telecom suspension rules and hold a stakeholder consultation in view of Anuradha Bhasin versus the Union of India. However, this promise has not been fulfilled yet. India is called the internet shutdown capital of the world for a reason. In the last 5 years, we've seen more than 400 such cases. Arbitrarily cutting off someone's access to the internet is a blatant rights violation. And internet shutdowns are a very serious thing but they are being doled out with alarming frequency and also in cases of questionable proportionality. There is an obvious lack of transparency and accountability here. The IFF has called upon the central and state governments to comply with the directions of the Supreme Court of India and proactively publish all internet shutdown orders on official government websites and disseminate them widely through the media, to issue an advisory to district magistrates clarifying that internet shutdowns cannot be imposed under Section 144. And also, the central government should maintain a repository of all internet shutdown orders and make this repository accessible to the public.